that.
Oh, women had to be sent in a room. And it kind of goes into our next point with even with having systems, being able to go with the flow, because as we are all very well aware of, life does not go according to plan, and just being okay with good with the flow and learning some things that you can do while you're in with the flow.
We're back to man plans, God laughs.
Yes, exactly. So, but being okay with that and realizing that life still goes on, you can still achieve your goals no matter what's going on. You just may not achieve it with this grand scheme that you may have planned for yourself, and realize that maybe this original plan may not work for you. You know, so for example, you've once told me that you had a PhD in dieting at one point.
That's true, I do.
And now we have found that for her, it was developing a lifestyle that worked for her, that made her feel good on the inside and out, that also allowed her the freedom to eat what she wanted to, and then be able to take in other foods and share foods when the opportunity presented itself for you as well at the same time.
I agree, and it was a learning process.
Mm-hmm.
It was finding by accident mm-hmm. what works for me.
Mm-hmm.
And one thing about when you have this great plan and it does not go the way you anticipate it, and Murphy has taken over your life, I 100% can tell you that every time Murphy has jumped into my life and taken a great situation and made it the worst situation I've been in up to that point, something good happened later.
So
there's always something good coming.
Can you share a story maybe about that, about Murphy maybe?
Here's a small one. I worked very hard my entire life. Built a beautiful company and had the grave misfortune of trusting the wrong people. And so my entire retirement plan is no longer in place. That's horrible. You work your whole life, you lose everything. And now I'm a professional singer as a career. Who knew? And it's the best job I've ever had, and I've never had more fun in my whole life. And I didn't have this planned, but this horrible moment in my life led to this great moment in my life. So,
yeah, exactly.
That's something I hadn't anticipated, and yet mm-hmm. it's been the best.
Yeah, and then I don't know if you guys can hear it on the mic, but you might be able to hear my dad playing downstairs. And I would agree with this. My mom was super happy in her business growing up, and you can tell. One of the things I read recently was in the book by Simon Sinek, that leaders eat last, that the best service a parent can do is to be happy in their job, because when you go home, you bring it to your family. And my mom, even though she felt like she was a disservice to us not being there, she was actually being of service to us because she was doing what she loved and she was passionate about it. And so that fed into me and my sister and the rest of our family when we saw the importance of working hard, but also how important was to find something that you were willing to work hard.
And so this girl traveled a million miles with me
mm-hmm.
and even went to Wyoming on a job with me one summer. And I don't know how many miles of cable she pulled for me.
Too many.
So,
and mind you, this was 30 feet in the air. I was pulling cable. I wasn't on the ground either.
But on the way up there, we stopped in Aspen, and we were on the Continental Divide in July, in shorts, and she's standing in the snow.
It was really
and
cool.
And so, I've taken them to many places that they've never gotten to go,
mm-hmm.
because that's where my job led me. But another priority here, so I took you with me.
And exactly. And it was learning how to marry those things at the same time and realizing that you could say what you wanted to have happen and say, okay, I'm coming to work here. My kid's coming with me. Or, you know, because sometimes I think a lot of people don't take a stand with setting that expectation, letting them know what they want, especially as women. I feel like sometimes we're intimidated by stating what we want. You know, and what
well,
people
I was in a male-dominated industry.
Yeah, exactly.
And I always got what I wanted.
Yeah, so but you also made it very clear to me and my sister and my friends as well that you can never get what you want unless you ask for it.
And that's still true.
And I think it's also important for us to do that, to ask for it, but also be willing to let yourself know what you want and allow yourself to have those thoughts and realize that you are worthy of wanting something and be willing to work for it too.
And if you don't get it, that doesn't mean you never are going to get it.
Yeah.
It just means at that moment it wasn't right for you.
Exactly.
But often if you ask for something, you get it.
Exactly, and sometimes it just comes at you in a different way.
Truly.
For another example of this is in my life is that I knew I wanted to further my education. I never realized it'd come in the form of a master's degree or in the field that I'm currently in.
I would have never guessed that.
She wanted me to be an engineer, and I went in to be an ag major.
Yeah, we started out with veterinary school.
Yeah, but you wanted me an engineer before that.
Of course, this is my kid who came home one day and said, I'm going to raise show pigs, and went on to the Houston Livestock Show her first year and got first place.
So it's just one of those things that you just kind of have to be open to opportunities and realize that your calling changes as it goes through, and that kind of leads into
and work toward it. You work toward all this.
Very true. And I think that's the next thing I wanted to cover and kind of elaborate on. So something, so that kind of definitely goes into the next point, is that being able to go with the flow, and when things come up, not panicking, but kind of have some game plans just in case something does pop up, because because that's the guarantee of life, is that something's gonna happen and it's gonna change. Always. Car breaks down, or you can't go that day, or something doesn't work out at work, or there's a child sick, or you have to...
Kids throw a hiccup and everything. Yeah. And so I mentioned this to you yesterday, that man plans, God laughs.
Yes.
And being able to go with the flow is great. Mm-hmm. And I had mentioned to Kelsey previously that I've tried to make some healthy lifestyle choices, and I have anxiety when mm-hmm. it's time, when I have to eat anywhere other than at home. Mm-hmm. I sometimes have anxiety over that, because if I'm at home, I know exactly what I'm going to do. Mm-hmm. Well, I am a professional musician, and a lot of times we play venues that serve food.
Yeah, exactly.
That's great. However, when you go to a restaurant, the reason that restaurant is so fabulous mm-hmm. and has 5 stars is because their food is absolutely unhealthy for you, because it tastes fantastic. Mm-hmm. And the things that make food taste great is fat, salt, and sugar. Mm-hmm. And I love fat, but along with that comes salt and sugar.
Yes.
So trying to work around mm-hmm. that menu choice that is there, because I know we talked about this yesterday. If you ask for something, there's a 50-50 chance you'll get it. If you don't ask for it, there's a 100% chance you will not get it.
Yes.
So I have found that when we play these shows mm-hmm. at a place that prides themselves on serving food, mm-hmm. that if I tell them what I want, they will accommodate me. For instance, here's a for instance. I love this for instance. I love pasta, and I did not take that from Oprah, who loves bread. However, they make pasta out of zucchini, mm-hmm. butternut squash,
yep.
and some other vegetable. I don't know what it was.
Carrots and things like that.
No, carrots.
Yeah.
Carrots have lots of sugar, which is all good and anything. I'm talking about me. And it had this white wine something sauce on it. I said, you know, I want that pasta. That fake pasta, mm-hmm. or maybe healthy pasta, that would be a better word.
Vegetable pasta.
So would you put some Alfredo sauce on it? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And they did. Mm-hmm. The wait staff went nuts. That night, everybody that worked for them ordered what I ordered.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
And they said, would you put some grilled chicken on that? I would.
Exactly.
And so they did.
Exactly.
So for me, that was going with the flow.
Mm-hmm. Well, and I think the other thing for me is just realizing that one meal out or having something that's slightly off track isn't going to derail you either.
I think that was hard for me to learn, but she did get that beat into my head.
It took a couple of years.
30? Oh, no, you're only 27. Yeah. Oh, wow.
I know, but I had to get old enough to talk to you, so...
You got really interesting to me about
25 years.
Yeah.
To talk to you about
it. I know. You started several years ago.
Exactly.
It worked, though. So, persistence, that's important as well.
No joke. And so, but learning that everything's going to be okay, asking for what you want, but also realizing that just use what you have and don't be afraid to ask for it. So sometimes when I'm in a case like that, I'll ask for a very plain salad with dressing on the side, and then I'll have that first with like chicken, and then I'll have my pasta. That way I'll have had the nutrients and stuff for my body, and then I can enjoy the pasta till in full, or if they have a vegetable option, or whatever the case may be, but just being open for it and also be willing to go with the flow. And remember that the next day you can start back on your routine. Nothing changes.
Valuable lesson. Listen to this. This I should have listened to a lot longer.
Yeah.
So earlier ago.
Yeah, and it'll be okay.
too.
It has been okay because now it's made my lifestyle sustainable.
Correct.
And before, I just felt punished all the time. I don't feel that way anymore.
Exactly. And you do the ketogenic diet almost exclusively now, with some lifestyle adaptations here and there, which is great. It's been great for you.
I have a goal here, and Kelsey's always pushing me to introduce more complex carbohydrates into my diet. She finally got across to me how much protein I need to be eating a day, and that was a hard sell, even though I love protein. So when I get to this, I now have stages to progress toward my goals. And I have a goal set out here at which time I will start introducing those more complex foods because I know they're good for me. And I have decided that I'm worth doing what's good for me and instead of putting myself last. And it's been great.
Exactly. And that kind of goes to the next one, is that expectation for ourselves is to all, like, the next point we want to make is our expectations. What are those expectations of ourselves? What do we want to achieve, but also are we being really realistic about what that is, but also understanding that maybe that scale weight or that dress size, whatever the case may be, should not be our only form of progress. It's important to acknowledge that, don't get me wrong, because there's research to show, you know, waist size and things like that for heart disease and things like that, but also realizing that feeling good, being able to do the things that you love, being able to live the lifestyle you want, play with your kids or grandkids or your friends or whatever the case may be, that is just as valuable as all the other stuff.
Or be a rock star at this age. That's
exactly. And that's just as important, you know, and also realizing to be able to go to a social function and not have an anxiety or have a game plan if you're very hard pressed on a goal. There's nothing wrong with bringing your own food. If that's the case,
I went to a party last week and I brought my own food.
And there's nothing wrong with that. And you have to be willing to say, you know, I have a goal, this is what I'm working toward. And the one thing that I've learned, and I know you've done it before, because I remember this growing up, is that people will challenge you about whether you're really going to try to go for that goal or not.
As if it were their business, because it's not.
Exactly. But also, it truly makes you understand that it's, for this part of the process, it is all about you. It's one of the few things in the world.
Women will sabotage you. And you know, sometimes it's subconscious.
Exactly.
However, you don't have to see it as that.
Correct.
I see that as, well, you know how it is. Mm-hmm. You tell me I can't do something,
I'm going to do it anyway.
Back up, Sally, because it's coming.
Exactly. But also just realizing that sometimes it's not a reflection of you, what they're saying, but truly a reflection of them.
Always a reflection of them.
And also just realizing that you need to have empathy for that, because sometimes they're in a different stage of their journey than you are, and they haven't learned some of the lessons that you have. And that's also vice versa, that maybe you're not where they're at because you haven't learned those lessons to be able to sustain that type of lifestyle as well. I mean, so we were talking yesterday that being able to have a six-pack set of abs or whatever the case may be, when I was competing in bikini and I was almost stage ready, and people were walking up to me and go, why are you in the gym? You look so good. You shouldn't need to come anymore. And
guess how I got there?
Exactly. And it was the realization I had to teach people was that in order to stay that way, I had to keep working for it. And also that once you get there where you don't stop, you actually have to be able to maintain it. And we have this start-stop kind of mindset about this whole thing.
That finish line thing, there's not a finish line.
Yeah, and that once you get there, all the work is done. And it's not how that works. A lot of time it's figuring out how to get there, and then you modify your lifestyle in order to either maintain that or alter it to fit where you're at. You know,
or move forward to somewhere you didn't even expect you were going.
Exactly. Give yourself the belief that you can achieve that. I mean,
oh yeah, look at my career.
Exactly. You never would have imagined going from owning your own industrial business, retiring, and then having a whole other career that you never would have imagined if you hadn't been open to the opportunity, trying new things and being able to jump off the cliff when necessary.
Jump off the cliff, you know, that's the career I have now is in entertainment, and people will tell you, even when you're younger, well, you can't make a living doing that.
Yeah.
Well, that they might not can, but I can.
Mm-hmm.
And that's because, once again, it's the asking thing.
Mm-hmm.
I go ask for what I want. And so I have gotten shows that you would never guess you would get because it's an impress kit, and I went for it. And I've been turned down a million times, but it didn't stop me.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the same way with my life. You know, people say, you're happy all the time. I'm not happy all the time. I am most of the time because I choose to be and I work at it. But that's my goal, is to enjoy every day to its fullest.
Yeah.
I get slapped down, I get back up again, because that's, I can control that 100%.
Exactly.
How much in your life can you control 100%?
Almost nothing.
You.
Yeah, nothing. And we need to realize that, that the only thing we can control is ourselves.
And that's a full-time job.
Exactly, and because we ourselves, I think especially as women, we have this belief that we can control everything.
We can control that.
Exactly, and because, you know, whether we have families or careers or whatever, our thing is we have this belief that we kind of have to control everything versus actually manage.
That's a good word. That's had kind of a bad reputation, but manage is a good word.
Yeah, because we sometimes, you can't control what's going on, but maybe you can direct the traffic.
I can control my reaction to it.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, like right now, there's some things going on in my life that should probably put me in the closet crying.
Yeah, exactly.
But I choose not to do that because, okay, if that would change the situation, I'd do it, but it won't.
Exactly.
So I will not do that. I'm going to go on and be happy.
Exactly. And that kind of fits into something else I probably want to touch on.